Good morning to all. So after the last class, we have completed almost of all the concepts about the sequence and series, that is about the AP, GP, HP, and as well as AGP, all the concepts that we have completed. So, and based on that, we have solved some different types of the models also on it. But we require to practice much more questions on that different models. Okay. And practice yourself. And we also provide some worksheets or assignments and practice from that also. And if you have any doubt, we can post me. And today's class, we have seen about the sum of the n terms of the some special series. How to find the sum of the n terms for the some special series? Already I have explained that method. But for the some students have joined in recently, lately, those students, they missed those concepts. So once again, we will practice the problems on some of the series, some special series. Okay, keep the subheading as sum of n terms of special series. Sum of n terms of special series. Okay. So what is meant by the sum of n terms of the special series means, suppose if the given series is not in AP or not in GP or not in AGP, then how do you find sum to the n terms of that particular series? So already we know the procedure for that. To find the sum to the n terms of that type of the series, what we have to do is, first by observing the first three or four given terms of the series, we have to write the nth term of the series. Okay, first by observing the two or three terms of the given sequence, then we have to write the nth term of the given sequence. For that particular nth term, if you apply the formula, the sigma, then it is going to give sum to the n terms of the sequence. Okay, suppose if there is a sequence, so that means it is a sum of the first term plus second term plus third term plus and so on up to the nth term. So this entire summation is, we'll call it as a sum of the n terms, that is we are going to represent by Sn, sum of the n terms. So this is the sum of all these n terms. Okay. Now this is representing the summation. So we know that generally the summation is going to represent by the symbol called sigma. Sigma represents the summation. So within the summation, if I keep the nth term, where n is going to vary from 1 to n. So then this end, all, the sum of all these terms is going to be represented by the sigma. That's why sigma Tn is going to represent sum of all the terms of the series. Or this is, you can also represent like that, because here the suffix is varying 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to the n, means in that series the suffix is varying. That's why that is variable I can take as then tr simply, where r is varying from 1 to n. So sigma represent, that is the symbol or notation we will use it to represent the sum of that term. And whatever the thing it is varying in the given summation, that variable you take is an R, a K, whatever you want it, you can take that variable. That variable is varying from 1 to N. So this summation we can represent in the sigma format as like this or like this. Understand? Means, first we have to find the nth term of the series. Sometimes they may give the nth term, sometimes they may not give it. If they are not giving the nth term, so you have to find the nth term of the given sequence first. So finding the nth term, for that particular nth term, just simply keep the sigma. If you keep the sigma, then it is going to give sum of the n terms of the sequence. Okay? If you want to find this sum of the n terms, basically you should aware about the five formulas at the starting classes I was given for everyone. So those five formulas we have to remember. In that, the first formula is that, what is the formula for sum of the first n natural number?
N into n plus 1 upon 2.
This is, we can also represent as then sigma n. Means sigma is in the sigma, if I add the nth term, that is going to give sum of all these numbers. That is sigma n, that is n into n plus 1 by 2. Then, what is the formula for sum of the first n even natural numbers?
N into n plus 1
square. N into n plus 1.
Nth even number. Nth even number will represent by the symbol called 2n. 2n is nth even number, so that is simply represents sigma 2n. That 2n. Is n into n plus 1. This is also the formula I was given to you. Sum of the first n even natural number. Similarly, sum of the first n odd natural number, 1 plus, 3 plus, 5 plus,
n square.
Tell me, what is the nth odd number will take it?
2n minus 1.
Minus 1.
2n minus 1.
Remember that. Whenever an odd number series start with 1, its nth odd number will take it. Is it 2n minus 1? Whenever an odd number series start with 3, then that nth term will represent by 2n plus 1. Remember that point.
1.
This is in the sigma format, it represents sigma 2n minus 1. What is the value of sigma 2n minus 1? Sum of the first n odd natural number is?
N square.
The formula we have to remember. Then the fourth formula is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus and so on up to the n square. So this is simply represented as in sigma n square. That represent sum of the first n square natural number. This formula is?
N into n plus 1 by 6.
By 6. Good. Then the next formula is that 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus and so on up to the n cube. That is the sum of the first n cube natural number that represented by the sigma n cube. What is formula?
N cube.
N square into n plus 1 whole square by 4.
Okay. So, for finding the sum of the n terms of that given series, we are going to use any of these formulas. Okay? So, these formulas, we have to remember it. Now, we will practice some problems for finding the sum of the n terms of some special series. So, first we'll solve the problems on this, which were asked about the different competitive examinations. That, look at the first problem. First, look at this first one. Sigma k is equal to 1 to n, k into k plus 2. So we have to find it. This was given in the Telangana State MCET 2017. The Telangana State MCET 2017, that problem was given. So, we have to find, because already the nth term was given, that is n into n plus 2. So, here the variable is given that k. Now, we have to find the sum of the series. Whose nth term is this? Means, you have to apply the sigma to that. To apply the sigma, whenever you find the product of the term, first multiply all those terms, then multiply by sigma. So, if you multiply by the sigma, it is a sigma k is equal to 1 to the n. First term is k into k. K square plus second term to multiply by the k, which is 2k, where 2 is the constant, the 2 can write outside the sigma, k is equal to 1 to n k. Like that, we will split the sigma, means we will multiply by the sigma all those terms. Now, if we expand this sigma, this is going to represent, if you keep the k is 1, which is 1 square plus, if you take the k is 2, 2 square plus 3 square plus and so on up to the n square, means this is going to represent sum of the first n square natural number. Now what is the formula for it? Sum of the first n square natural number is?
N into n plus 1 by 6.
That is the formula we will write it. Plus 2 times, this is sigma k. Means if expand that, k is 1. What is 1 plus? 2 plus? 3 plus, 4 plus, up to n, we will get it. That is going to represent sum of the first n natural number, that is n into n plus,
n
1,
into
by
n plus 1 by 2.
Okay, so like that we will write the formula. After writing the formulas carefully, we have to simplify this. The simplification also will be easy if you go for any particular order. If you get the two terms like that, from that both the terms, something is going to come common. Take it as a common. From these two, what we can take common?
N into n plus 1.
Upon 2 will get common. Remaining is 2n plus 1 upon 3 will be there, plus 2 will be there here. Now here, what is the LCM is?
6.
2.
3 is an LCM.
3 into 2, 6 we will get in the denominator.
6.
N into n plus 1 into after the LCM, then the numerator will get the 2n plus
2n 7 by
7. 3 to the 6, 6 plus 1, 7 upon 6. So this is the
2.
Sum of that n terms of the series. That is n into 6. N plus 1 into 2n plus 7 by 6. Understand? So this is the procedure to find the sum of the n terms of the series. Understand? Take that.
Yes, sir.
Look at the second problem. So what is the nth term of the series? So it is a simple question. What is the nth term of the series? It is 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 2 by 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 by 3 plus and so on. This is the sequence. So this is given in that AMU 1981. AMU means, that is, sir, 1982.
N plus 1 divided by 2.
Good. So some of the n terms only we have to find it. We have to find only the nth term, not the sum of the n terms. So AMU means, that is Aligarh Muslim University. So to find the nth term of the series, first we have to observe that first three given terms. So observe the first three given terms here. In the first term, in the numerator, you can find one term. Second term, you can find sum of the two terms. Third term, you can find sum of the three terms, etc. So nth term, you'll find sum of the n terms. 1 plus, 2 plus, 3 plus, and so on up to the n, we will get it upon. First term, there is a 1, second term, 2, third term, 3 in the denominator. So what will be the nth term? N.
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 So by observing the three given terms, we can assume the nth term as like that. Now, the numerator represents the sum of the first n natural number, that is n into n plus 1 by 2. By n, so where n and n is getting cancelled. So therefore, the nth term is n plus 1 by 2. This is the nth term. Okay? So they ask you about the nth term only in this problem. Suppose if I want to find the sum of the n terms of that sequence, we have to apply sigma to this term. That is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 constant added outside. Apply the sigma. Since there is a two terms are there, means you have to multiply by the sigma. First term is sigma n plus sigma 1. Sigma n plus sigma 1. So that is 1 by 2 into, where sigma n represent n into n plus 1 by 2, sum of the first n natural number, plus. What does sigma 1 represent? Sigma 1. So sigma means there is a summation. 1 means there is a constant, means every time there and so on up to the 1, means we are adding the 1 by the n times. So n times, if we add the 1, then what we are getting? N times, if you add the 1, that what is the total summation is? N.
N.
So therefore, remember that. sigma 1 value is always equal to n. Okay. Now we have to simplify this. If you want to simplify this, what we can take comma from these two?
N.
N. N I can take comma. So at the outside already by 2 is there. So it's n by 2 into. The remaining is that n plus 1 by 2 plus 1. So here LCM is 2. So 2 into 2, it becomes 4 in the denominator. That is n into 50, the LCM is 2. N plus 1 plus 2, that is n plus 3. Therefore, the answer is n into n plus 3 by 4. That will give the sum of the n terms of the series. Okay? So take that. Look at the plan number 3. What is the sum of the n terms of the series, which is 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on up to the n terms. So you have to find sum of the n terms of the series. So this is the problem which was asked in the Madhya Pradesh PET 1986. So we have to find sum to the n terms of the series. Okay. Now if you want to find that, here the procedure is same. First, by observing that first three given terms, we will add the nth term of the series. So Tn is equal to, just observe this term. First term, we can find only one term in the bracket. Second term, we can find sum of the two terms. Third term, we can find sum of the three terms. So nth term will get the sum of the n terms. So those are 1 plus, 2 plus, 3 plus, and so on up to the n. So this is the nth term. So we know the formula for the sum of the first n natural number is n into n plus 1 by 2.
N plus 1,
2. By 2. If you multiply by the n, this is n square plus n by 2. So this is the nth term of the sequence. If you want to write the sum of the n terms of the sequence, which is Sn is equal to, just we'll apply the sigma for before every term. So where 1 by 2 is the constant right on outside, after that keep the bracket, then multiply by the sigma, these two terms, that is sigma n square plus sigma n. Like that we'll multiply by the sigma.
N into n plus 1 into n plus 2 by 6.
Good. 1 by 2 into sigma n square. We know the formula for sigma n square is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by
6
plus sigma n is n into n plus 1 by 2. Okay. So like that we will write the formula. Now from these two, what we can take common?
N into n plus 1 by 2.
N into n plus 1 by 2. We will take the common. What is the remaining? 2n plus
1
by 3 plus 1. Okay. Now carefully we have to simplify this now. So at the outside there is an n into n plus 1 by 2 into 2, that is 4. And here the LCM is 3. LCM is 3. What we'll get in the numerator? 2n plus 4 will be there, right? Now from these two terms I can take the 2 common, right? But is the 2 common, 2 to get cancelled? So 2 and 2 gets cancelled. The remaining is n into n plus 1 into
n into n plus 2.
2 by 6 will be there because the 2 is getting cancelled here. So 3 into 2, 6. So that is a sum to the n terms of the sequence. Okay, take the problem.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
completed, sir.
Okay, let's look at the next problem. Fourth one, just observe this. Three upon one square plus five upon one square plus two square plus seven upon one square plus two square plus three square plus and so on up to the n terms. So we have to find some of the n terms of that sequence. So this is the problem which is given in the Punjab CET 1999 and Rajasthan PET in 2001. So we have to find the sum to the n terms of that sequence. Just observe that. So first, by observing that given term, we have to write the nth term of the sequence. Okay. To write the nth term, once observe the numerator first. Here, first term there is a 3, it is 5, it is 7, etc. Right? Yes, if you observe that, here we can find the numerator, all are the odd numbers only, and that too, that odd number started by 3. So we know that if any odd number series started by the 3, what is this nth odd number?
2n plus 1.
Therefore, in the nth term, the numerator will have 2n plus 1. Now look at the denominator. First we have the 1 square. Second, we can find sum of the 2 square terms, sum of the 3 square terms in the third term. So in the nth term, we have 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus and so on up to the n square. Sum of the n square terms will be there. Now this 2n plus 1 upon, what is the formula for the denominator?
n into n plus 1 upon 6.
2n plus 1 upon 6. Where this 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1 gets cancelled, the 6 goes to the numerator, 6 upon n into n plus 1. This is the nth term of the given sequence. Okay. Now, whenever if you find the nth term as like that, means here you can find that n are there in the denominator. Right? So, this model of the problem already has explained to you. In the denominator, if you find the product of the two terms, the denominator...
Sir, 6n upon n plus 1?
Good. So in the denominator, you find the product of the two terms. So to find its sum of the n terms, already I have given the procedure to you. What is the procedure is that, look at about their difference. First, look at about the difference. N plus 1 minus n, that is 1. That's why the numerator, this is taken at 6 into 1. By n into n plus 1, I can write it. So if that difference is not there in the numerator, multiply and divided by that difference. Then, that 1 in the numerator, I can write as n plus 1 minus n, I can write it, upon n into n plus 1. So that 1, write down as the difference of these two terms. Now split the terms. It is 6 times. If we split the term, first term where n plus 1 upon n into n plus 1, where n plus 1 gets cancelled, remaining is 1 by n minus. Second term is n and n gets cancelled, remaining is 1 by n plus 1. Understand? So this is the nth term of the sequence, we got it. Now if you want to find the sum of the n terms, here we can't apply the sigma straight away. Sum of the n terms means that represent t1 plus t2 plus t3 plus and so on up to the tn. That's why first keep n is equal to 1, you will get the first term. Keep n is equal to 1 here, it is 6 times. Keep the n is equal to 1, which is 1 by 1. That means 1 minus 1 by 2 is the first term. Plus, keep n is equal to 2, then you'll get the second term. That is 6 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. So from all of them, 6 is there in the common. So I can take the 6 outside. Then it is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. This is the second term. Plus, keep n equal to 3, you'll get the third term. So it is 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus etc. Lastly, if you keep n is equal to n, that is the last term is 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1, we will get it. Okay? So this is 6 times. Here you can observe that all that middle terms are getting cancelled. all the middle term gets cancelled except the first term and the last term. This 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 will be there. So here the LCM is n plus 1. Then the numerator is n plus 1 minus 1. So that for 1, 1 gets cancelled. Answer is 6n upon n plus 1. This is the sum of the n terms of that series. Understand? So whenever you find the product of the two terms in the denominator, look at about their difference. If the difference is there in the numerator, already one is there, one you can write it. So that one will write the n plus 1 minus n, then split the terms. They will get the difference of these two terms, you will get it. Now, first keep n equal to 1, you get the first term, plus. Take n equal to 2, you get the second term, plus. Like that goes on adding all the terms. If you add it, obviously for all the problems of this model, you will get the first term minus last term only will be the remaining. So directly also can write it. First term is 1 minus last term is 1 by n plus 1. If you simplify that, you will get the sum of the n terms of the series. Okay. So take the problem. Okay. Now, look at this problem number 5 of this problem. It is 1 square upon 1 plus 1 square plus 2 square upon 1 plus 2 plus 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square upon 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on up to the end term. We have to find sum of n terms of the series. So this is the problem which was given in the Karnataka CET 2011. Try to solve the problem.
N plus 2 by
3. N into?
N into N plus 2 upon 3.
Good. N into N plus 2 upon 3. So, it is a simple question because since we are preparing for the object 2, that's why always try to write the direct steps. Don't try to write all the steps because here I am writing all the steps for your, for explaining to you only. But generally for practicing it, so try to write the direct steps only. Most of the steps you have to calculate in the brain. So don't try to keep everything on the paper. So here, just observe that what is the nth term? So nth term means here we have, can find up to the 1 square in the numerator. Here you can find sum of the 2 square terms, sum of the 3 square terms. So in the nth term, you'll get the sum of the n square term. Sum of the first n square natural number. So that formula directly you can write that it is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by that will be there in the numerator. And in the denominator, there is one term. This is the sum of the two terms. There is a sum of the three terms. So nth term will get the sum of the first n natural number. That formula is n into n plus 1 by 2. So then here n into n plus 1 gets cancelled. 2, 3 also get cancelled. The remaining we can find that 2n plus 1 by 3. This is the nth term of the sequence. Now to find the sum of the n terms, we have to apply the sigma to every term. Here 1 by 3 is the constant written outside, and if you apply the sigma, so that is also, don't try to write on the paper, directly calculate the answer for that.
Sigma plus
sigma 2n. Sigma 2n. Already we know the formula for that. Sigma 2n represents sum of the first n even natural number, that is n into n plus 1. Sigma 2n will give n into n plus 1 direct formula plus sigma 1, which is n. Sigma 1 is n. So now from these two, I can take the n common. Remaining is n plus 1 plus 1, that is n plus 2 by 3. So like that, in every problem, try to finish within 3 or 4 steps. Don't take much more time. Yeah, take that.
Done, sir.
Okay. Done, sir. Completed, sir.
Done, sir.
Okay. Next, so look at the next problem. So the next problem, sixth one. Is what is the sum of the first 10 terms of the series? Sum of first 10 terms of the series that is 1 3 by 5 whole square plus 2 2 by 5 whole square plus 3 1 by 5 whole square plus and so on. This is the series was given. Plus 4 square is there here. Plus and so on. So this is the series. In that I have to find the sum of the first 10 times of the series is given as 16 by 5 into m. Sum of the 10 terms of the series was given as 16 by 5 into m. Then what is the value of the m? Then m is equal to how much? This is the problem. So this is the problem which is given in the GMAIN 2016. GMAIN 2016. Okay. So up to now we have solved the problems which are given in the state level examination. And this is the GMAIN level examination. We can observe the difference between the way of asking the question. In the state level examination, they ask about the direct question. Direct question they ask about it, okay? Means some of the end terms, so simple equations or expression or sequence only they have given. But here they have given the sum of the 10 terms. Sum of the 10 terms means compulsory you have to find the nth term. In that nth term, sum of the n terms you have to find it. In that you have to keep n equal to 10. Means it is an indirect question. That's why for every GMAIN question, little bit logic compulsory will be there. That you should understand. Now, just observe the series. 1, 3 by 5. How do you write it? 5 into 1. 5 plus 3, that is 8 by 5. 8 by 5, whole square we can write it. Plus. Second term, dekho. 5 twos are 10. 10 plus 12 2, 12 by 5. 12 by 5 whole square plus
16 by 5.
5 threes are 15 plus 1, that is 16 by 5 whole square